Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in the last video, we have installed MongoDB on the Ubuntu operating system. So in the today's video, we will see how we can secure this database. After installation of MongoDB, this is very important step as authentication is disabled by default. So first step to secure this database, so we will have to create one admin user so we can use this user to connect to the database. And then we will enable the authentication from the configuration file. So let's add one user. So first connect to the MongoDB shell. So we can use command mongo sh. So authentication is disabled by default. So you can use this command without any option. So let's fetch the list of databases. So we can use command show dbs. So you can see there are 3 dbs. So let's use admin db. So this is where all the user information is stored, like username, password and roles. So let's fetch the list of users. So we can use command db get users. So currently there is no user. To create user, we can use command. This is the JavaScript function. So you can change the username. So I am using admin and I am using role user admin any database and read write any database. So this will grant the user to read and modify any database and any user. So press enter. This will ask for password. Enter your password. One user is created. So let's fetch the list of users. So you can see one user is created. So first step is done. So now let's enable the authentication. Clear the console. Exit from Mongo shell and clear the console. To enable authentication, so first open the file. So you can use this command. You can use command nano and you can find the mongo configuration file in etc folder. Press enter, uncomment the security line and paste authorization enable. Save this file and then you have to restart the MongoDB service. So we can use command restart. So now let's connect to the MongoDB without any option. Mongo sh. So if you try to get the databases, so you are getting this error because we have enabled the authentication in the configuration file. So exit and let's connect with the username and password. So we can use command have created admin user. And enter the password. So now we are connected to the database. So let's fetch the list of databases. So as you can see, this is working fine now. So in this way, you can create a user and secure this database. In the next video, we will see how we can configure this database in such a way that we can access this database from remote. So if you find this content useful, please like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more such videos. Thanks for watching.